Hey guys, I'm Tefel from Archaeo Project. In this guide, I will show you how you can create really functional doors with opening and closing and some matching sound effects. I hope you enjoyed this. Okay, so once again, we have doors with a cracking effect and this closing effect. So everything what we need is just doors, one static mesh, one sound for closing, and this is a queue with five sounds, random sounds, and it's creaking effect. Yeah. Okay, so we can just create a new blueprint from door, and it will be open door blueprint. Let's save. Okay, and inside we have static mesh. We can just rename this to door and add a stand component. It will be our root. Okay, next one will be arrow, which will be base, and we make child door because we want to rotate this base instead of door. And one component will be just sphere collision, and it will be just trigger for our doors. Yeah, and make this bigger, 200. Okay, so in event graph we can just use our trigger, and when it's bedging overlap and when it's an overlap. Rest we can just remove. Okay, so everything what we need is just one timeline, which will basically will be changing door, so maybe just opening door. Okay, so when we just trigger this, we should do this only once. And when it's completed, we just play sound at location. We don't want to play sound all over again when we just overlapping, just only once when we started to open. Yeah. Okay, so it will be playing, and when it's end overlap, we just make sequence, and first one will be just reset, and second one will be just reverse mode, so it will be closing. So when it's updating, everything what we need to do is just get our base and set rotation. It will be relative rotation, so we just split this, and inside our timeline we need to create a float track, and of course value it will be 0 0, and second value will be 1 1, length 1, use last keyframe, adjusting this. And one more thing, we need to make interpolation automatically. Yeah. So it will be much smoother. Yeah. Okay, so it will be really nice effect of opening and closing doors. And I think it's everything from here. And when it's updating, we get this new track, which is from 0 to 1. And we need a LERP, which is linear interpolation. And it is our alpha from 0 to 1, and it's from 0 to 90 degrees. Yeah. And we can just link this and check this out. Okay, and one more thing, when it's finished, I need to play sound, but only when it's closing. So we need to check direction, if it's equal our backward, and using branch, of course, when it's true, we just play sound. We can copy this. And of course, we need to assign this sounds. So I need to make this smaller and just take my door close sound, and second sound, my door open. Yeah. So this is everything from here. Let's check this out. And I need to put this door on my Steam. Yeah. Okay, let's check this out. Okay, and it's rotating, but we need to adjust this position. So once again we go to viewport really quickly, and we need to move this door and our trigger, and we have our arrow, so you see where is just middle of this. Yeah, So it's like that, it will be opening. So we can just save and check this out once again. It's opening, but we need to rotate this because handle is on the wrong side. So once again, and we can rotate this door 180 degrees. And once again, yeah, I'm pushing this lever, yeah. Okay, so it works. I can also add this to my scene to be more accurate, and let's check this out. Okay, and it looks really good. Okay, maybe higher. Okay. Okay, so from now you should know how to make fully functional doors. Okay, so see you next time.